gardening season, September 2023. This video is called Aunt Molly's Ground Cherries. Now, this is a really cool plant, gardening plant, for getting fruit or any kind of food, because it's a fruit, but this truly does taste like a fruit because it's so sweet. Now, this bed right here, I'm going to post a picture right here of what I how I made it. It was just built this spring. It's a brand new bed, just built right on top of the ground, filled with 2-year-old leaf humus. And I think it's like 6 foot by 4 foot. And actually, you'll see that this one plant, which I measured to be about 8 feet across, I should have actually just put one plant instead of 6 plants. I also got celery, eggplants. I should have just put this in the middle of the bed, right in there. And who knows how big it would have gotten, but you got to give these plants plenty of room because they'll grow, especially if you got some nice composted soil. So anyways, this is a ground cherry, which is a wonderful fruit that is really nothing like a tomato. It's also known as a Cape gooseberry and a husk cherry or a strawberry tomato. Here's a close-up of that. This is why they call it, there's the husk right there. And inside is protected fruit. Now, it's a strawberry tomato is another common name because I guess it tastes like a strawberry, but it's still not even a tomato. It's its own thing. So the Latin name is Physalis pruinosus. It's the Latin name. I probably butchered that, but that doesn't matter. It's a ground cherry is the common name, and the variety name is called Aunt Molly. There it is right there. And you could see when they're ready, they hit the floor. And right now it's September, so they're starting to really drop right now. And that's when you know that they're ripe. So it's an heirloom variety from Poland, prized for its unusual fruity, fine flavor. It's very sweet with a nice hint of tartness. Now those fruits, these guys right here, they're 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch fruit. It's enclosed by that papery husk, which drops to the ground when they're fully ripe. Their high pectin content makes them excellent choice for baking. So there are health benefits to it and also disadvantages of pectin. You'll have to look up those for yourself. But these little golden yellow 1/2 inch fruits are excellent for pies, preserves, jams, and fresh eating with a strawberry-like flavor. They are massively productive plants, 18 inches tall, and they say on average 4 feet, but mine, I measured it, it's at 8 feet from end to end. Now they start fruiting in July and they continue until the frost. Here is, oh, there, it just fell off right there. I wish I would have got that. But look at how productive they are. And when they're yellow like that, it just dropped off. And that'll be when they're at their peak flavor right there. They start in July, they go till the frost, and it's an indeterminate. So if we had the weather, I'm a zone 5, they may fruit forever. Look how productive. That's one little branch. And every branch is just loaded with them. Look at that, just fell off right there. So, let's talk about this. This variety, it's a delightful combination of sweet and tart. Now, ground cherries are sweet cousins to the tomatoes and the tomatillas. Kids of all ages love finding these tiny wrapped packages and eating the yellow fruits like candy right out of the garden. Or several weeks later in a fruit salad or over ice cream is a perfect combination. They'll store actually up to 3 months in these husks. Where is that? Let's open it up. Isn't that cool that they're protected like that on like a tomato? So they have a long shelf life. So actually there's a nice little history about this. Aunt Molly's came to a seed company called Territorial. It was on an unnamed line. So they selected it and released it as Aunt Molly. And it's named after Tom and Julie's first business, Aunt Molly's Ice Cream Treats. So they actually perfected this from the species. That's kind of cool. Now this Physalis species, they're tasty summer treats that are even more mineral densely packed than tomatoes, believe it or not. It's packed with unique phytochemicals and flavonoids. So I find that it takes a while for them to germinate and grow. So you could start them indoors sooner than your peppers and tomatoes. This is a zone 5. They seem to actually do better with a additional heat if you use a plastic mulch that will get these guys bacon. They must love that heat. They're great for snacking. Look at these little guys. I'm going to just grab a little handful here. The initial taste is so familiar that I can't even figure out what it is, but it's definitely a sweet, fruity flavor. Now remember, since the fruit drops to the ground, you may think that they're not edible, but it's just the opposite. It's the second they hit the floor is when they're at their top flavor peak. So I've noticed that if you let them sit on the shelf for about 5 days, that they fall through a flavor dissipation. And it's just that sweet flavor, but it's still really pretty awesome. It's my palate was confused, but these wonderful little fruits have me over the moon. It's hard to wait for them to fall off the plant and hit that floor, but the yellow fruits, when they fall, they're delicious. As others have said, it's hard to describe the flavor. I'm thinking it's more between a cross between a peach and a pineapple. They're really sweet. So let me know what you think yours tastes like. I can't wait to get to the point where they're falling off the branches. They do get quite large, which is not really a problem. Just make sure you have plenty of space for these prolific plants to spread out. You will love them, and since you will miss a couple of the husks, you'll find volunteers popping up in your garden. Direct sowing them fares to be a better way to grow them. They're a little stronger, but you could do transplants as well. Just give them plenty of room and they'll be like this one. They'll get about 8 foot across with hundreds of ground cherries. Totally recommend it. Probably one of my best things in the garden just because they're so sweet. Better than a tomato. Here's the label. But look at the size of the stem. Like literally this thing has got to be at least about an inch and a half. It's incredible the size of this guy. And look at just from yesterday. There's more. That's overripe now when it's cracked. Look, they're just all over the floor still. These are fresh ones right here.